And Shiloh before the Lord. And there Joshua apportioned the land to the people of Israel, to each his portion. The lot of the tribe of the people of Benjamin, according to its clans, came up, and the territory allotted to it fell between the people of Judah and the people of Joseph. On the north side, their boundary began at the Jordan. Then the boundary goes up to the shoulder north of Jericho.
As I told you, from chapter 14 to 21, the Bible tells us allotment for people of Israel. So each tribe, Judah, Manasseh, from yesterday we learned, Joseph's tribe, there are two, Ephraim, Manasseh, but they are one tribe. So except for Levites. Levites is a unique tribe. They have a portion, but God said God is their inheritance. So each tribe, they get their inheritance from the land of Canaan. So, 18, verse 1 to 10. Actually, seven tribes. Only seven tribes left for remaining lands before Judah and what kind of tribe. They already finished to get their inheritance. So seven tribes, they still have responsibility to possess their own inheritance. So 18, 1 to 10, the Bible is describing there is remaining land in the Canaan for seven tribes in Benjamin, Simeon, Zebulun, Issachar, Asher, Naphtali, and seven tribes, they still, they didn't get their portion. So the seven tribe, they also possess their portion. Then Joshua, he asked the seven tribe, you go to the land, and verse 4 to 7, 4, 6, 8 says, verse 4. Joshua, actually verse 3, there remain among the people of Israel seven tribes whose inheritance had not yet been apportioned. Seven tribes, they didn't get their portion yet. Then, so Joshua said to the people of Israel, how long will you put off going in to take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, have given you? You can feel the mood. You can feel the voodoo, and all the other tribes, they get their portion already. Why? They must fight. Not automatically. God promised, this is your land, promised land, that God says, you fight to get this land. But these seven tribes, they hesitate. They must go to war. They must fight. But they are hesitating. And then Joshua rebuking them. Why you hesitate? you go fight and get your land. And the verse 4 says, he commanded these people, provide 3 men from each tribe, from 7 tribes. The Joshua said, you take 3 men from your tribe, and then I will send them out that they may set out and go up and down the land. They shall write a description of it with a view to their inheritances, and they come to me. Joshua said, you go. And then, your life description means you grow. How beautiful and how long you grow like a man. And then you bring and come to me. He gave assignment. You go to the land and you grow. And then verse 6 and verse 8. And you shall describe the land in 7 divisions and bring a description here to me, and I will cast the lot for you here before the Lord our God. So he says, Joshua said, you grow. Then, if you grow, I will cast a lot for you before the Lord. And some preacher, they interpret this, Christian, you have a great vision, and you grow your vision in your dream, and then God, he will give you this land or money. So, Christian, you must be great, have a great vision, like growing your land. That's a misinterpretation. Who give this land? Because of their growing or God promise. You know, verse 3 says, Joshua said to the people of Israel, how long will you go going in to take possession of the land which the Lord, the God of your fathers, have given you? God already given them. Not because of their great dream or drawing. God already had given them this land. So they must remember God is the one who has given this land to them. Not because of their great vision or dream, God already promised and given them. Okay, after that, they receive their portion in inheritance according to this instruction of Joshua, then 18:11-19. 48, there's a story in Genesis 4:7-5. Okay, they follow the Joshua's instruction, and then they brought their drawing description, and then the Joshua cast a lot, and then each tribe they get their portion. So verse 11 to chapter 19, you see that verse 11 to 20, inheritance of Benjamin. And later, chapter 19, inheritance for Simeon, inheritance for Zebulun, inheritance for Issachar, Asher, Naphtali, Dan. So this is very simple story. each tribe, they get their inheritance. But we want to see some special story, like a Simeon and Ben. Simeon, actually Simeon, chapter 19, verse 1 through 9. Simeon so we don't have time now, but Simeon, they get their portion from the tribe of Judah. Verse 1 says, the second lot came up for Simeon, for the tribe of the people of Simeon, according to their plan. And their inheritance was in the midst of the inheritance of what? Of the people of Judah. This is weird. Simeon, they get inheritance from the inheritance of Judah, not their own portion. Their portion from the Judah's inheritance. Not separately. And then in the history, the Simeon described the scattered in the Old Testament later. And which means their portion, their inheritance is not big, because they get from the Judah's tribe. And then in the history, the Simeon, they are scared, and in the history they are just gone. Do you remember the story in Genesis? Simeon, Levite. They have their sister and other nation, the prince take advantage from their sisters. And then Simeon, Levites, they made a plan to kill these people because they take advantage from my sister. Do you remember this story? And then his father Jacob, chapter 49 in Genesis. Jacob, before he died, he blessed his children. Chapter 49 is the last will of Jacob. So Jacob blessed each his children, and then this is like a prophecy. Chapter 49, 5-7. Simeon and Levi are brothers. Weapons of violence are their sword. You see that they are like a weapon of violence and their sword. Why? They kill many people because of sister. And then, let my soul come not into their counsel, for my glory did not join their company. For in their anger they killed men, and in their willfulness they hung some oxen. Then, verse 7 says, cursed be their anger, for it is pierced, and their wrath, for it is cruel. I will divide them in Jacob and scatter them in Israel. You know, this is like a prophecy for Simeon Levite. Long time ago, his father predicted these two tribes, they are cursed because they kill many people, and they will be scattered in the Israel. In the God's word, you know, this is the Jacob's blessing and promise for each tribe. Then this is the God's word, promise of God. Promise of God exactly fulfilled in the story. Simeon, when the tribe get in their portion, Simeon, they get only small portion, even tribe from the Judah's tribe. Because of Jacob's prophecy. How about Levite? Simeon Levites. Levites, they have a portion. Curse. So Jacob, he said, curse on them. Levites have no portion. But blessing is there. Levites, even though they have no portion, they have a business to serve God. Levites. Okay. But I have many contents, but you are just taking the time. Okay. So, Levites, they are also the promise. The Jacob says you are first, but Levites, they are like a priest. In the Leviticus, Exodus, we know that Levites people, they are serving tabernacle, and they are serving the many things for offering. What does it mean? Levites, they are not first anymore. Because of story in Exodus, Levites people, when Aaron and people made the golden calf, Moses angry with them, and Levi's people, they killed their brothers and sisters. Almost good? More than 2,000 people. And then the Bible says they are devoted. We will not find, but you know that story? Actually, we all senior, we are like a Levite and Simeon. And even though we are under the curse of sin, if we come from sin and turn to God, repent our sin, God, keep blessed. Our life, come from death to life and darkness to the light, like a Levite's device. And then, chapter 19, verse 14 to 48. Then also had their portion. But verse 47. When the territory of the people of Dan was lost to them, the people of Dan went up forth against the shame. Then after capturing it, striking it with the sword, they took possession of it and settled in it, calling the shame Dan at the name of Dan their ancestors. The shame. Then, they are very unique. They get their portion from the lot. After they wrote their description of, like they get their portion, but then this tribe, they went up. Northern part. they left their own portion, but they went up by themselves. And they get another land. Let's share. How does it mean? God said, like Ellen, you get your portion, this one. But Ellen, he just left what God given to her. And then she just go to another place, and she get by herself something, by herself. She left what God promised, but she get other portion by herself. You know what I'm saying? No, then they just broke what God promised, and they just moved to another place by themselves. And the place name is Leshem. You know the reason why I'm explaining this story then? Georgie 1:34. Maybe this week we finish Joshua, then we will start the Georgie next week. Chapter 1, verse 34. The Amorite pressed the people of them back into their own country, for they did not allow them to come down to the plain. You see, Amorite people pressed the people of them back into the hill country. They did not allow. You know, the bad people, they did not follow what God promised. And then they moved to another place by themselves. And the result is that the Gentile Amorites, they press this band. What is the result? We Christian, if we do not follow what the God promised, God's will, we get another terrible manner in our lives. Amorite people, they push and press towards these people, and then they could move to the kingdom. And last, in Acts 1:4, Joshua, all tribes, they get their inheritance. And lastly, the Bible describes Joshua, he also gets his portion. Verse 15 and 51. By command of the Lord, they gave him in Joshua, the city that he asked, Timnath-Serah, in the hill country of Ephraim. And he rebuilt the city and settled in it. Actually, 49 says that when they had finished distributing the several territories of the land as inheritance, the people of Israel gave an inheritance among them to Joshua, the son of Nun. You know, God gave inheritance to the Joshua, but 49 says, people of Israel, they collect some inheritance for Joshua. You know, God gave Joshua inheritance by the Israel, people of Israel. And the place is Timnath-Serah. Is Timnath-Serah from the country of Ephraim? Ephraim. This land taken from Ephraim's tribe. But later you read my book. In Ephraim, inheritance Ephraim, this Timnath-Serah is not there in the Ephraim. You read Bible again later. Timnath-Serah, the Bible says, this land taken from Ephraim, but in the inheritance of Ephraim, there's no this name. What does it mean? Joshua, even though he get from the land of Ephraim, his place is his own, his own. His very own inheritance. This place become very own Joshua's place. Verse 51 says, these are the inheritance that Eleazar the priest and Joshua the son of Nun and heads of the fathers' houses of tribe of people of Israel distributed by blood at Shiloh before the Lord at the entrance of the temple meeting. So they finish dividing the land. They finish dividing land. What does it mean? Joshua complete his mission. Do you remember chapter 1? God called Joshua, be strong, courageous, you brave, and I will be with you. You conquer this land, you can get this position with your people. And 51 is like a conclusion. Joshua, he cleared his mission with his people. And he get his also inheritance. This Timnath-Serah is very special, very particular reward. This is special reward for Joshua. Because other tribe, they are not like a Joshua. Other tribe, one person, like a Joshua, one person cannot get their land. But Joshua and his family, they're just one family, but they get their own land for one family. This is very special reward. We Christian, we also have this hope. Like a Joshua, we must be faithful to God's promise. Then He reward our dedication and our sacrifice and our faithfulness. He never forget your dedication and your effort. Like Joshua, he surely reward and bless the people who are faithful to his promise and his prayer. Father, we want to be like Caleb and Joshua, fully trust God and fully obey God's promise. Then the people like Caleb, Joshua, who are faithful to you, you may bless and reward their obedience and their faithfulness. Lord, in the end, we all stand before you And we want to hear your compliments, my son, my brother. Well done. And you clear your mission. Lord, we want to hear the voice. You admit our faithfulness and our efforts on this journey. Not only in the end, but while living in this journey, we want to see your reward and your blessing. Lord, you help us not to hesitate to get your blessing and your promise, but to be brave to conquer what you promise for our life. You be with us. We want to be strong and courageous in every time. In Jesus' name I pray.